How are you all? This is Sukumar. I'm a mathematics teacher. Today, our topic is polynomials. Second chapter in CBSE and third chapter in AP State Board. This is the very important chapter. See, what is a polynomial? A polynomial is an algebraic expression. It's an algebraic expression which consists of variables and coefficients. It consists of variables and coefficients, and it involves operations like addition, subtraction and multiplication. The main condition of the polynomial is the powers of the variables must be positive integers. They must be positive integers. See, for example, I will give you an example here. 3x cubed minus 5x square plus 10. Here the variable, what is the variable here? Variable is x. So what are the coefficients here? The coefficients are 3, minus 5 and 10. These are the coefficients of x cubed, x and x power 0 respectively. So understand children, topic is degree of a polynomial. What is the degree of a polynomial? The highest power of the variable. Highest power of the variable is called degree of a polynomial. See, for example, 3x power 5 minus 5x cube plus 5x square minus 10. Here highest power of the variable is what? 5. Therefore, the degree of this polynomial is 5. Understand, students? The next one is degree of a monomial. What is monomial? Monomial means it's a single term is called a monomial. See, the degree of monomial means sum of all the powers of the variables is called degree of a monomial. See, for example, 3x square y to the power of 4 z power 6. It is a monomial since it has a single term, right? So what is its degree, children? Degree is equal to 2 plus 4 plus 6. That is equal to 12. So 2, 4, 6 are the powers of the variables x, y, z respectively. So its degree is 12. The next topic is, you know, already you have learned about types of polynomials. See, there is a linear polynomial according to their degree. So what are the types of polynomials? The first one is linear polynomial. Linear polynomial means the degree of the polynomial should be equal to 1. So such a polynomial is called linear polynomial. For example, ax plus b or minus 2x plus 3. These are the examples of linear polynomials. Here the degree is 1. X power 1, x to the power of 1. Right. Next one is quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. What is a quadratic polynomial? See, a polynomial having the degree is equal to 2, such a polynomial is called quadratic polynomial. That means ax square plus bx plus c, where a is not equal to 0, of course, this is a quadratic polynomial. So what is the degree of the quadratic polynomial? It's 2. Like that, cubic polynomial. These are all topics you have learned in 9th class. Just I am reminding you whether you understand these topics or not. Cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. So for a cubic polynomial, its degree is 3. 3 means ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. This is a cubic polynomial. The next topic is, let us learn about zero of a polynomial. Zero of a polynomial. What is the zero of a polynomial, children? For some value of x, some value of the variable, the polynomial, the value of the polynomial will become zero. So, for what value of x or variable that value becomes zero is called zero of the polynomial. That means, for example, ax plus b. Here, let it be y. Y is equal to ax plus b. So, a into minus b by a plus b. So, here these two gets cancelled, minus b plus b. This is 0. That means, at x is equal to minus b by a, this polynomial becomes 0. Therefore, x is equal to minus b by a is called 0 of a polynomial. Understand, children? The graph of a linear polynomial is straight line. Straight line. That means it intersects the x-axis at exactly one point here, like this. As you know, this is x-axis, y-axis. You already learned these graphs in 9th class also. Look, here this linear polynomial represents a straight line. It represents a straight line. So it intersects the x-axis at one point. You already know that the degree of linear polynomial is 1. So it intersects the x-axis at one point. The number of zeros, the number of zeros of this linear polynomial is 1. Understand, children? Here the degree is 1, number of zeros is 1. It intersects the x-axis at one point. That means there is a relation between the degree of a polynomial to the number of zeros. Similarly, you can guess, children, quadratic polynomial. So here the degree is 2, therefore the number of zeros, number of zeros are 2. I will draw a graph for this quadratic polynomial. As you know, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. See, this is a parabola. The graph of a quadratic polynomial is a parabola. It's a U-shaped curve. Look, at how many points this parabola intersects the x-axis? Yes, 2 points, here and here. So the 2 points, let it be alpha comma 0 and beta comma 0. Since it is intersecting x-axis, you know that the y coordinates become 0. Therefore alpha comma 0 and beta comma 0. So the zeros, the number of zeros are 2 here. The number of zeros are 2, since this parabola intersects the x-axis at 2 distinct points. Not distinct, 2 points, at 2 points. Next one is cubic polynomial. You are right. See, it intersects the x-axis at 3 points. Since the degree is 3 here, it intersects the x-axis at 3 points. Therefore, number of zeros, the number of zeros of this cubic polynomial are 3. Number of zeros are 3. Understand, children? So this is geometrical meaning of zero of a polynomial. Here in this sum, in this graph, this is a straight line which intersects the only y-axis, not x-axis. Therefore, the number of zeros are nothing, zero. Here, this curve intersects the x-axis at only one point. Therefore, the number of zeros is one. Here, it intersects the x-axis at 2, 1, 2, 3. Therefore, the number of zeros are 3. Here, coming to this graph, have you ever seen this graph? Yes. I have given an introduction, no? Right. This is a quadratic polynomial. This is the graph of a quadratic polynomial. This shape is called parabola. Right. This graph or this parabola intersects at 2 points with the x-axis. Therefore, the number of zeros are 2. Coming to this graph, it intersects the x-axis. Count, children. 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, the number of zeros are 4. Here, this graph intersects the x-axis at 1, 2, 3. So, the number of zeros are 3. Thank you.